here. Now, as I have told you in the earlier class only, the main, the crucial role will be played by the sensors, right? The crucial role will be played by the sensors. Why sensors? Why only sensors? No actuators are there, nothing is there. Why? Because sensor, in the name itself, it is given sensor. It can sense. I have told you the parameters also. What are the sensing parameters? I have told you in the earlier class. The first one is temperature. Okay. The next one is pressure. And the third one is humidity. Okay. And the last but the not least is motion. Now, these are the four parameters which are very, very important in the design of IoT or in the working or operation of IoT. Why? Because the sensors, as we have seen, we are familiar with many type of sensors, right? But all the sensors, whatever we are using in our daily life, they are very, very dependent upon these parameters only. Because without these parameters, no sensor will going to work in a systematic way. For example, let us take temperature. Why temperature? Temperature means in externally the temperature can be cool, the temperature can be hot, the temperature can be medium. So that temperature input should be captured by which sensor? Temperature sensor only. Specialized temperature sensor only, right? It will capture the input in the form of temperature. Then I have told you in the other class, it will pass that input to the main block of an embedded system, right? In which the A2D, D2A, CPU and everything will be there, right? Then from that actuator, okay? So that is the concept. That's why I have told you the basic of embedded system. Why? Because for knowing IoT, you must and should know embedded systems, okay? So pressure, there are different types of pressures in our world, right? So for taking the pressure input, for taking pressures as an input, we should use pressure sensor, right? It is also one kind of input parameter, not output parameters. They are all are input parameters. Input in the sense, I am told you what sensor, right? Next, humidity. Humidity is also one of the measuring input parameter. So for measuring the humidity, for taking input as an humidity, we should take humidity sensor. Next one is motion. Next one is last but not least is motion. See, we took temperature as an input, we took pressure as an input, okay, we took humidity as an input, okay. Last one is motion. Why motion? Why? Because for example, let us take an example of PIR sensor. Okay, now let us take an example of PIR sensor. Okay, what is PIR sensor? For example, PIR sensor means for infrared radiation sensor. For example, my body, I am walking around, I think 15 kilometers or 15 meters, and I have kept the sensor in the range of 15 meters only. So what it will do, if somebody is coming inside from the door, entrance door, it will capture that radiations and it will give that radiations, it will take that radiations and it will pass on to the things which are required, right, which are required to be operated. For example, let us take this room. For example, I will take the example of this room only. For example, here the lights are there, fans are there. How they are being operated? I am simply switching on the light, switching off the light, switching on the light, switching off. So it's not an IoT. If I want to convert this example into the IoT, what I will do? I will fix a PIR sensor. I will fix the PIR sensor at the entrance of the gate only. So whenever I am coming inside, my radiations will be captured by which sensor? PIR sensor. Okay. So PIR sensor means I'm moving. I'm getting into the motion, and that motion is being captured, or the temperature is being captured, or the pressure is being captured. Everything is being captured by the different kinds of sensors, and they will be given to the they will be, and that input will be given as an input to what? Lights, fans, and all the instruments, whatever we are using. So depending upon these parameters, my home appliances will work through internet, through internet. So that's why here the mobile app I have drawn. That's why here I have drawn the mobile app example. Why? Because mobile app, in mobile app only we can use the internet, right? We can use the internet in the mobile app only. So you would be surprising that you have drawn the cloud server, you have drawn the IoT gateway framework, you have drawn the sensors. So what about internet? That is the main thing. So internet I am using from the mobile. I have told you the app. So I have designed my IoT projects in UB.S app, right? I have designed my IoT project in UB.S app. There I have designed the parameters, whatever you are seeing here on the blackboard. I have designed the parameters by programming it and network configurations. Okay, so I have told you that network programming and normal programming is very, very different. So that's why IoT programming and embedded system programming is somewhat different. They both are not same. So that point is clear. Okay, so through the mobile app internet, what I am doing, I am switching on my devices. My devices can be anything, light, fan, TV, everything, washing machine, anything we can switch on, we can switch off according to the mobile app internet, right? So that internet is being collected through the cloud server. What is cloud? As everyone are being familiar with the cloud computing and everything nowadays, cloud is very, very important subject, cloud computing. So cloud computing is nothing but readily available computer resources or the data which is useful for operation of the things in an automatic way without any human intervention or direct intervention of human being, right? So that is the cloud computing, where the computing will be done automatically. What is the computing? Calculations. Okay, now, so calculations will be done automatically. So that's why cloud server is very, very important. It is like a headquarter hub where all the information is being gathered and it is separated according to the devices, what device, what, which one, right? So what is IoT framework gateway? What do you mean by IoT framework gateway? This is the third block I am going to explain. See, as we have studied in CAO, Computer Architecture Organizations, what we have studied, the information will be passed in the form of packets. What am I? The information will be passed in the form of packets. Okay, so there are, for example, there are 8 bits are there, right? 8 bits are there. As you have studied there, sender one will be there and the receiver one will be there, right? Sender and the receiver, right? So this start bit and stop bit are like the engines for the message bit. Let us assume this as a train. This is the front engine and this is the back engine. Start bit, stop bit, and in between this start bit and stop bit, the main information, encrypted information, will be there, which is useful for working or operating of any device, right? So it will be sent from source to destination. At the source, I am attaching this start bit and I am attaching this stop bit, and at the destination, the person will remove this start bit and stop bit, and he will receive only the important data, whatever he wants. So it is being done not with the help of internet, it is being done with the help of protocols. As we have studied, SMC protocol, SPC protocol, so many protocols are there, communication protocols, that are networking protocols. But coming to the internet protocols, they are very much different from the networking protocols. So that message passing, that communication controlling, that network capabilities are being handled by IoT framework gateways. Okay, so if we want to pass any message from one device to another device with the help of internet, this block will play the major role, IoT framework and gateway. Okay, that's why I have given the example of the CAO message bits, right? Okay, cloud server is collecting the information and sending to the required destinations, right? This mobile app we are operating, and here only we are operating through internet. And these sensors, what are these sensors? Sensors means input. They are capturing the input which are coming from the this networking thing, right? It may be in the form of temperature, it may be in the form of pressure, humidity, motion. So this is the complete block diagram of an IoT. Okay, only four blocks you must remember. First one is cloud server, which is very very important. After that, mobile app. Through mobile app only we can use the internet and we can operate the things whatever we want. Okay, then for the communication purpose, for exchanging of data between the two devices, IoT framework and gateway is very very important. And for capturing the input, sensor is very very important. So these four blocks are very very important in architecture. Now coming back to the next topic, now I am going to explain about functional block of an IoT. You would be surprising that what is the main difference between architecture and functional block of an IoT. Both are same, but the main difference is that in architecture you are only watching the external view. Now you are going to watch the internal view also, that how it is functioning, right? How it is functioning. Functional block diagram. Change the heading. Functional block diagram. So it is very easy. See, I will draw a big rectangular block. In that block, the four blocks will be there, the semi blocks. What are that? First one is application. Okay. First one is application. Device. Management. Sorry, the space is not there. Will adjust. Management. Security. And in between, the two half blocks will be there. The two half blocks are services. And the second one is communication. Okay.